Hello everyone, today we will start AMWay search tree. What is AMWay search tree? This is multi-way search tree and it is also a BST or binary search tree. But it has M pointers and M-1 key values per node. Okay, so AMWay search tree properties. What are the properties? Each node can point at most M subtree. Okay, each node can point at most M subtree and the number of keys in each node are maximum M-1 and each node can have maximum M pointer. Okay, and these two lines can be better understood by this example. So let take AMWay tree. So representation of this AMWay tree. So P0, then this is K1, P1, K2, P2, KM-1. PM-1. The P0 represent pointer and K1, K2, these are represent the element or item. Okay. So suppose you see here 50 is the element. Okay. And this is the key value. And P0, P1 are two pointers. Okay. As I told you, it is a binary search tree. We know in a binary search tree, the right subtree is always greater than the root node and the left subtree is always less than the root node. Okay. So here you see this pointer will point to 60. As 60 is maximum, it must be the right subtree of this. Okay. And here 40. So 40 as less than 50. So it must be the left subtree. Okay. So let construct a three-way search tree. In a three-way search tree, maximum 3 pointers can be used. Okay. So value of M equal to 3 means the number of subtree can be 3. Okay. And always we have to remember, suppose we are representing this P0, K1, then P1, then again K2, then this is P2. So 3 pointer are there and how many data can be present? K1 and K2 are the element of data and only 2 data can be present and 3 pointer can be used. And we have to remember always the K1 always less than the K2. Okay. So here you see the example. So before going to the example, let us discuss some properties of this AMWay search tree. All keys values in the subtree pointed by PI will be less than KI+1 and key pointed by PI+1 will be greater than KI+1. Okay. This can be better understood by the example of this. Suppose 10, 60, 100, 240 and 120. Using this data, we have to create a three-way search tree. Okay. So M equal to 3 as it is a three-way search tree. So first we have to take 10. Okay, we have taken 10. So P0, P1. Okay, then we can take another element. Suppose we have taken 60. Okay, because in a three-way search tree, okay, as I told you, in a three-way search tree, what we can use? We can use one data, then another P0, then P1. Okay, then another K2, this is K1, then another P2. Already I told you, we can represent this way. Okay, so here we can accommodate 60 here and another pointer is P2. Now we have to insert 100. So 100 is always greater than 60, we know. So this pointer P2 will point to 100. Okay, so P2, it 100 must be the right hand side and it come to the right hand side and P2 point to 100. And then we can insert 200. 200 cannot insert at the left hand side because 100 is greater than this 60. Then again compare to this 100. So 200 will be inserted on the right hand side of the 100. Okay. So it becomes the right child. Okay. Then we can put null pointer here because there is nothing. Okay, then we have to insert what? 40. Then 40 will compare with this root node. 40 is less than 60 and it is greater than 10. So it must be the right child of 10 and it must be the left child of 60. So P1 point to 40. Okay, then 120. 120 must be compared with 60. So 120 is greater than 60. So it comes here. Again it compare. Okay, but 120 is less than 200, but it is greater than 100. So it must be the right child of 100 and left child of 200. So P3 point to 120. And all elements are inserted. As there is no element, we have to put it as null pointer. So hope you have understand this and you have enjoyed this video. Now you have to create another three-way search tree using the element 20, 70, 110, 210, 50 and 130. This is the task for you. Have a good time.